Hello friends, my name is Dheeraj Vaidya from WallStreetMojo.com. This is the part 3 of our ratio analysis video series, and in this installment we will learn all about horizontal analysis. In simple terms, horizontal analysis calculates the percentage change in the financial statements over two or more accounting periods. So it basically helps in evaluating year over year or quarter over quarter trends. So in this tutorial we have basically four objectives. Number one, to understand what horizontal analysis actually means. Number two, to look at its formula and its calculations. Number three, perform horizontal analysis of Colgate. And number four, look at its interpretation. But before we jump into the tutorial, a quick reminder. We will need the working files of Colgate case study for this video. So if you haven't downloaded it yet, then please do so from the description link below. And also, to keep yourself updated with investment banking and core finance concepts, please do subscribe to our channel, Wall Street Mojo. So let's get started. So let us now understand what is a horizontal analysis. So horizontal analysis is actually a part of the ratio analysis framework, and it comes under this company's trends. So where we can see that we did discuss about vertical analysis. Horizontal analysis is actually defined as the changes in the financial statements over the two accounting periods. What do I mean by this? Is basically we look at how the financial statements like income statement items or the balance sheet items, how have they moved from first year to another second year. So how has been the growth rates, etc. That's what is basically done in the horizontal analysis. The accounting period could mean we can compare the 2 years, like 2019 to 2020, 2020 to 2021, or it could be a quarter over quarters, quarter one versus quarter two, or maybe quarter one of 2019 versus quarter one of 2020. So you can do that kind of analysis using horizontal analysis. Let's move forward and look at the exact formula. So here we have the horizontal analysis formula, which says the amount in the comparison year minus amount in the base year divided by amount in the base year into 100. Don't worry, this formula is very, very simple. Say for example, you have sales in 2021 and that was, let's say, 100, all right? And the sales in, let's say, 2020 was 80. What is the growth rate? Is basically this formula is all about. What is the absolute growth? Absolute growth would be how much? In absolute terms, it will be 100 minus 80. That is $20, right? That would be the absolute growth. But the percentage growth would be this absolute growth divided by the base year, that is the year of 2020. That's the base year, right? That's what the comparison year is all about. From how 2021 sales has moved with respect to 2020. That's what we are trying to calculate. This comes out to be 25% because we need to multiply this by 100. This is how you can do your horizontal analysis. Usually we don't use these formulas like absolute and then go about dividing this by the absolute with the base year and multiplied by 100. We usually use this shortcut. The shortcut is pretty simple. What you need to do here is you need to press equal to the sales year of 2021 divided by sales year of 2020 and do a minus 1 here. According to the rule of board mass, this will get divided first. And then minus 1 will happen. So this comes out to be pretty much the same answer. Since it's in a decimal, you need to put a percentage here as well. This is how you get the horizontal analysis done. So we have done it for sales. You can do it on cost of goods sold or EBITDA or net profit and other items as well. You can do the horizontal analysis for the balance sheets and the cash flow items as well. So now that we have understood what horizontal analysis is and how do we go about doing it, let's look at our Colgate case study and do horizontal analysis in that as well. Let's move to that. This is the Colgate formula of income statement. And if you scroll down, you might have noticed that we already did the vertical analysis in our last lecture. And this time we'll look at horizontal analysis. First thing first, you need to understand that when we have to start calculating the growth rates, we will need the base year, right? So we can't start from the first year itself because we don't have the data for 2015. If you had that data, you could have started from 2016. But since we don't have this data here, prior to this one, we don't have the base years. The base year becomes this one. So the first year from where we start this growth rate calculations is December 17. Okay. Now, another thing to note here is that we will calculate the horizontal analysis, that is the growth rates for all the line items within the income statement, like the cost of sales, gross profits, profit after tax, everything, right? Let's do that. For doing that calculations, we will use that shortcut formula. And the formula would be net sales of 2017 divided by net sales of 2016 minus 1. Here I'm putting this as equal to, I'll scroll up, find the net sales item, that is 15474 divided by 15195 minus 1. I hope you remember we just did this formula as a shortcut formula to calculate growth rates. And when you press enter, you will have this as 1.7%. Why it is percent already? Because I pre-formatted this sheet. So you might have to press percentage in your sheet. All right. So that's one thing. This way you need to complete this whole section of horizontal analysis. I can do this pretty quickly by just copying this formula and pasting it across, and I keep on doing it. The idea here is to, you know, copy paste the formula so that the formatting also is not screwed in one way or the other. So the best way to do is only to copy formula using the paste special method. I will do a control C. Okay. I will select whole area here. I'm just showing it as a shortcut. Do a right click, go to paste special and choose the formula. And when you choose the formula and press OK, what happens is that this formula gets copied across all the lines. Though you don't need these, you can delete that. But this formula is pretty handy. You can go and use paste special formulas. What are the observations by doing this horizontal analysis? What we note here is that horizontal analysis, the net sales have increased by 5%, but our operating profit has increased by 9.3%. So that's pretty high. So we are getting to the right kind of, say, questions, right? Cost of sales has only increased by 1.4%. What happened to the raw materials, you know? Things like that needs to be investigated. Second is that on one side, we had the gross profit that increased by 7.4%, but the net income only increased by 3.1%. You are getting to the right kind of questions to actually ask within the case study. And the better way would be that once you are equipped with these questions, you need to go to your SEC filings and try to find the answers, whether management has discussed the answers to those questions or not. So that's how we do horizontal analysis. A typical way in which it is very useful for financial analysts is that it becomes a starting point for projections. What do I mean by that is, I'll just scroll down and I'll show you what it actually means here. Here on line number 84, what you have is this bifurcation of, regions. The revenue growth rates from different regions, right? So now that we have understood horizontal analysis, it has some amazing applications while you are forecasting. So I'll show you a sample here. Why don't you scroll down and reach this point? This is line number 84. So this is nothing but the bifurcation of the revenues of Colgate-Palmolive across various segments and regions. Oral, personal and home care is one of the regions, one of the segments. And the second segment is pet nutrition. What we have is the bifurcation. So how much comes from North America, Latin America, Europe, South Pacific, Asia, Africa, and Eurasia. So we have these distributions, right? Let's see if you have been given a task to forecast the sales of Colgate-Palmolive in 2021. This is the place to actually start off with. Apply horizontal analysis on each of the segments, like the way we have done. So I'll do that once. Basically, what I want you to do is to calculate the growth rates for each of the segment. So here we have this North American segment between December 18 and December 17. It has grown by 7.4%. likewise, you calculate the growth rate for each of the segments. So I've done this here, and I want you to actually complete this exercise. And I'll do it pretty quickly by copying this whole section and then pasting it across all the relevant places. Okay, this is a very quick way of doing it. You can also try the same. What are the observations here? Is that North American region has grown by 9.3%. Likewise, 5.2% degrowth in Latin American region. Europe has grown by 12.1%. So let's say if you have to forecast based on these growth rates, you can actually forecast the future growth rates, right? So that's how you basically do it. Going forward, you know, as per your understanding about the company, since it has grown by 7.4%, 2.3% and 9.3% over the past 3 years, percent or 8%. So likewise, you can go about, you know, putting these growth trends for the future years. So this would be for, let's say, 2021, 2022 onwards. So on the basis of that, you can actually find the sales numbers for the North America section. So this would mean that in 2021, you expect the sales to grow by 8%. And where this 8% is coming from, basically I've taken a judgment call. I've just taken an assumption. I'm assuming that based on these growth rates, it might grow by 8%. I know that this is a very, very simple way of doing it, but for a practical approach, you might also have to refer to the SEC filings and the management discussions as well, apart from doing your horizontal analysis. So you can do the same for the remaining segments as well, and complete and find the forecasted sales numbers for Colgate-Palmolive using horizontal analysis. I hope you found this video to be useful. Please do like and share. And if you have any feedback or want to suggest a new topic for any future video, then you may do so by writing about it in the comments section. Also, we come up with interesting videos on investment banking and core finance topics very regularly. So if you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, please do so by clicking on the subscribe button below so that you can get the notification as soon as we release the latest video. I hope you enjoyed the video. Have a nice day. Thank you.